हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ एक्सप्रेशन फॉर मैग्नेटिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑफ अ शॉर्ट मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल और अ मैग्नेट। वी नो दैट इफ एनी मैग्नेट और मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल इज फ्रीली सस्पेंडेड इनसाइड अ यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ऑफ इंडक्शन बी बार, देन इमीडिएटली इट इज एक्टेड अपॉन बाय कपल। व्हाट डू मीन बाय कपल? द एक्शन ऑफ टू इक्वल एंड अपोजिट फोर्सेस। सी हियर, एन पोल it is acted upon by magnetic force in the direction of induction, S pole in the opposite direction. So these two equal and opposite forces forms a couple, and no doubt turning ability of couple is expressed in terms of vector quantity called as a moment of couple or also called as a torque. Already we derived formula for torque. Torque acting on this dipole is equal to mv sin theta. So this is equation number first. Now in order to rotate this dipole through certain angle theta, suppose initially when theta is 0, sin 0, 0, then no torque is acting. Means initially dipole is at rest with axis parallel to induction. If we are interested to rotate this dipole through certain angle, say small angle d theta, then 100% certain work must be done. Because as soon as we try to rotate this dipole, immediately this torque comes into play. And against this torque, certain work must be done. Now we know that in linear motion, work done is given by formula W is equal to force into displacement. Now if small is the displacement, small is the work done. So dW is F into dx. In analogy with linear motion, in angular motion or rotational motion, this work done is given by force. You have to replace simply by yes, analogous quantity torque, and linear displacement with linear angle, yes, angular displacement d theta. So work done of rotational motion dW is given by tau into d theta. Now here, very very important point to be noted, it is again dot product of two vectors, so it is a scalar quantity. Now here, torque and angular displacement both are in the same direction, means we are applying torque in anti-clockwise, angular displacement is anti-clockwise, and hence in magnitude form, tau d theta cos theta, so theta will be 0, cos 0 is 1. So this is now basic formula in order to calculate work done of rotational motion. Now here torque is known to us, that is mv sin theta. So small work done dw, to rotate it through small angle, we can say that this is mv sin theta into d theta. Very very important, equation number 3. So this is the small work done to rotate this dipole through small angle. We are interested to rotate it through total angle of theta. Then what to do? Integrate. With total work done, we can say that this is integration of dw. So this is equal to, yes, integration, mb is constant term, into integration sin theta d theta. Now I think it's very simple. So work done is equal to minus mb cos theta. Why minus? Because integration of sin theta d theta will be minus cos theta. So this will be the formula to calculate work done to rotate this dipole. Now see here, work done, equation carries minus sign, which implies that work is done in the against direction of torque. Because torque is clockwise, work is anti-clockwise, hence minus sign is there. Now listen me carefully. Work done, we know that as per the law of conservation of energy, it is a kind of energy. And we know that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. But one form of energy can be converted in another form of energy. So to rotate this dipole, yes, through angle theta, whatever work is done, that complete work done is converted in, yes, potential energy which is stored inside this dipole. And hence, that potential energy stored itself is called as magnetic potential energy with symbol U. And as per law of conservation of energy, U is equal to W. So formula comes out minus mb sin theta. Equation number 5, very very important. This is formula to calculate magnetic potential energy of dipole. Now what will be its minimum and maximum value? So simply follow this equation. Here theta, if it is equal to 0, yes, tell me, when theta is equal to 0, we will get sin 0, 0. Yes, therefore, U will be minimum, yes, and is equal to, or suppose here theta is 90, sin 90 is 1. So initial case number 1, sorry, consider theta is equal to 90 degree. Yes, sorry, by mistake I have written sin, it should be cos theta here, because same formula we are writing. So here when theta is equal to 90, cos 90 is 0, and therefore, yes, this potential energy will be equal to 0. Second case, when theta is equal to 0, then cos 0 is equal to 1. So we will get U equal to minimum value, and that is minus mv. See here, due to minus sign it is minimum. So this is the intermediate value. And third case, when theta is equal to 180, yes, cos 180 is minus 1. Hence, potential energy stored, it is maximum, and that is equal to plus mv. Very, very important point. See here. This is the third case in which magnetic energy stored by the dipole is maximum when angle of rotation is 180 degree. So, and that is equal to mv. When it is rotated through angle 90 degree, yes, it is zero value. And when it is rotated through angle 0, then yes, its value is minus mv. Is it clear to you? So, this is about expression for magnetic potential energy of a short magnetic dipole. Okay, thank you.